Einhorn, Berkowitz, Grantham, Miller, Swenson. Learn as much as I do from these rare conversations with our exceptional guests. Check out my extended interviews with some of the world's great investors and financial thought leaders on WealthTrackExtra.com. Hello and welcome to this edition of Wealth Track. I'm Consuelo Mack. 2 years after the global financial collapse, we are still trying to understand all of the factors that contributed to the near catastrophe and its recovery. One of the few business writers with the breadth and analytical ability to unravel this puzzle is Roger Lowenstein, this week's financial thought leader guest. You quoted the late economist Hyman Minsky in your book, The End of Wall Street, and observing that success breeds a disregard for the possibility of failure. So having come through the Goldilocks economy, as it was described under the 18-year Greenspan tenure at the Federal Reserve, many investors and certainly people on Wall Street became convinced that they could never fail. Now, is there, clearly failure is very possible. Is there the opposite of that? Does failure, which we've just come through, breed something? Is there something that you know, is there another extreme that we're now experiencing?
You know, I guess fortunately, when we get to the other end of the cycle, now we're very much afraid. And you ask, you know, what does it breed? It breeds sound lending. It breeds people saying, no, I'm afraid to do that. I don't want to give you a loan. I'm going to treat all of you, good credits and bad credits, like a risk. And I'm going to be very careful about that. And people are afraid to go into the stock market, and they have a lower proportion of their assets in the stock market and so on. And that means that the choices people make are probably better choices, because if you're not lending to everybody, if you're just lending to a few people, you can be choosy. You can pick out the best loans. And if you're not buying every stock and you're not putting all your money into stocks, you can be choosy. So in this part of the cycle, people are much apt to make better choices. And that'll last for a while, you know, and presumably this time this cycle it'll last for a little longer, because the downside has been so terrible.
What about our views of the stock market and the notion of stocks for the long run? That in fact that they are the asset class that everyone should be in long term, to, you know, beat inflation, to keep up with the growing economy. Has that been seriously challenged, do you think?
I think it has been seriously challenged. Warren Buffett says, don't buy a stock unless you can afford to lose half your money, okay? And you know, we've seen that happen. Now, over 10 years, stocks are not better than bonds. Even over 20 years, this is as of the end of 2009, I believe, they were trivially better, you know, and given all the risk you were taking in stocks, they really weren't a good investment. I do think you should have a reasonable portion of your money in equities, but the idea that in all seasons, in all markets, you should always be, you know, virtually fully invested in equities, I don't buy that. And the idea even that the S&P 500 is always safe, I think that's been dealt a very serious blow. We have a long, long hole to climb out of. Japan is what, still a third of their all-time high that they reached, you know, more than 20 years ago. The NASDAQ, less than half of its all-time high that was reached 10 years ago. And the Dow, still way, way under its high. And it's, you know, negative more than 10 years.
So these are risky assets. You wrote a wonderful book, which I am in the middle of, about Warren Buffett, a biography of Warren Buffett called Buffett. And so what have you learned from Warren Buffett, I mean, about investing?
Well, the first thing is keep it simple. Buy the stuff you understand. You know, Buffett's never bought a technology stock. He says he doesn't understand it. You know, he's made enough money in things he does understand. You don't have to, as he says, swing at every pitch. There are no called strikes. You can let 1,000 good investments go by because you don't understand them, you're not sure about them, you don't feel well that day. It doesn't matter. They're always going to throw a new pitch at you the next day. Wait for one you're really sure about. Probably it's in a business you understand, maybe with a company you're familiar with. Be a little bit greedy about the price. Don't chase a stock, you know, going up. Wait, sooner or later, Wall Street's going to get depressed. Wait till they get depressed. When everyone's fearful, as Buffett likes to say, that's the time to be greedy. When everyone's greedy, that's the time to be fearful. And invest for the long term. You know, he likes to say, invest as if they gave you a card and you could punch 20 holes in it each time you bought a stock. And when you'd done those 20 punches, you were done for your career. You'd be pretty careful about the stocks. You'd say, is this stock is good, but is it worth one of my 20 punches? Do I want to use one up? Make every investment count. Because you know, every investing career is just a summation of all these decisions, which may seem small at the time. If you treat each one like they really count, you'll do better.